Now, if you know us here at GameRanks, you know we've spent plenty of time getting nostalgic and talking about the amazing Need for Speed Underground games. You know, the darlings of the early 2000s. But today we wanted to switch gears and dive into another gem of a street racing game in the Need for Speed series. Need for Speed Most Wanted, the original one. Maybe not the best Need for Speed game, but one that doesn't get enough love, even still to this day. It's really damn good. So today we're gonna dive into the question, what made Need for Speed Most Wanted a big deal? Now, first of all, man, like context-wise, Need for Speed Most Wanted had big shoes to fill. It released in 2005 and had to follow the big act that was Need for Speed Underground 2, which took a lot of the world by storm. Everybody loved the Underground games. It was just the height of the culture, the Fast and the Furious movies, all that was going on right now. And yet somehow Most Wanted did surpass expectations. If you ask fans, many think this is one of the best. Some others think it didn't quite come off as awesome as Underground did, but user reviews, critics reviews, and sales numbers show this thing blew everything out of the water. It was released November 15th, 2005 on Nintendo DS, Game Boy Advance, GameCube, PC, PS2, PSP, Xbox, and then Xbox 360. And it went on to sell a freaking whopping 16 million copies worldwide, making it the best-selling game in the series. I think some people forgot that. I know I certainly did, but damn. So there's a couple of things that made this game really special. Career mode was the main jam and where most people hopped into first, and it was a blast. This was possibly one of the few examples of the career story, setup, and presentation being actually fairly interesting. The idea was straightforward and simple, you know? You start out with an awesome car, it's sabotaged, and you're setting out to take down a special list of elite street racers called the Blacklist. Racing up that list and knocking out dudes, earning significant car upgrades for your dude along the way, really felt like a satisfying kind of version of Crackdown where you were in an open world taking down targets one by one, but with street racing. Now, throw in a great video game rival jerk character, Razor, a really solid and memorable soundtrack, and decent presentation with full video cutscenes that were interesting, and you've got yourself a great experience. Need for Speed did dabble in this type of cutscene thing, the FMV thing, for years. Sometimes cringy, sometimes passable, and with Most Wanted, it was just a really good way to play along. Was it a little cheesy? Yeah, but it worked here, and a lot of people really enjoyed it and were hooked on it. Oh, and your car. I mentioned you use a really cool car at the start, and then you unlock it again after defeating Razor. The BMW M3 GTR with the slickest wrap job. Man, that thing was iconic at the time. It graced the cover. It was a lot of people's favorite car in the game, and we're just pausing for nostalgia for a second. Anyway, let's talk gameplay. Story aside, most of the time though, you were straight up playing and racing. By Underground, Need for Speed had really nailed a good sense of speed, and that's no different here. The way the game makes you feel as you're racing, you know, the on-screen effects to show the element of speed, the air rushing by you, the nitrous boosting make it even crazier, some of the lighting effects, all this made for just white-knuckle, intense racing where sometimes you were holding your breath. Now, handling and drift and everything wise, every game handles a little differently, but it was fun here. Customization, unfortunately, wasn't quite as deep as the Underground games, but for most people, it seemed like everything else made up for it. Specifically just the bosses, the races, and all the pure fun that there was to be had. There was free roam through the fake city of Rockport and its three kind of varied areas. A nice little step up from how Underground 2 handled the free roam stuff. It felt more natural, but the best thing was the police chase system. Now, of course, Need for Speed was no stranger to police pursuits by this point, but people loved how they handled it here because it was a blast. get caught speeding in front of a cop. Full-on pursuit begins with a pursuit meter, an escalating heat level, and more challenge. The AI could get really crazy. Helicopters would show up, road spikes would be deployed to sabotage you, and you're trying to dodge and outmaneuver and outrace the cops, or take them out with a pretty fun destruction system. There were chase breakers you could clip and knock into specifically to break up the pursuit. One of my favorite was like crashing through a roadside donut shop and triggering like a cutscene with a giant donut to fall down and land on the cop cars. I don't know, that was awesome. Now after a pursuit, if you had too much heat, you could swap cars, and especially you needed to be careful because you didn't want to get your car impounded after getting caught with a three-strike system. You're engaging in this and checking out and tracking stats like length of pursuit and accomplishing milestones in this free roam world to work your way up to a new blacklist race. The race goes down, there's some presentation, there's some cutscene to it, and if you're good enough and you take down the racer through that, you get access to cooler cars and more car upgrade options, but you had to choose very carefully. The whole flow, the whole gameplay loop, it all just really clicked incredibly well for people. Underground 2, with more to do, an engaging story, and a great gameplay loop structure, what more could you ask for? Along with all of this, there was Quick Race, which is pretty much whatever type of race you want with whatever parameters and whatever car, a Challenge Series mode, which is all event-based and pretty much focused around pursuits and milestone stuff like Career Mode, but you unlock more cars for Career and Quick Race, which was cool, and certain versions of the game had online multiplayer. Basically, four-player online racing in a handful of different gameplay modes with evenly matched cars. Of course, this was 2005. You had to be really fortunate to have access to be able to play online. I didn't really much, but some people definitely engaged with it. I had some friends with more money. Also, it's worth pointing out that although this thing had various versions with slight variations on different consoles, the PSP version, the PlayStation Portable version, was like a standout, underrated version. It was called Need for Speed Most Wanted 510, and it was a pared-down version of Most Wanted for sure, but it was a ton of fun and played very well on the handheld. And it had a Be the Cop mode and a few other things in it that were exclusive to it that were pretty fun. Also, don't get it twisted, there is a newer Most Wanted game, and that comes up first when you Google it, so if you're new to this, be careful. EA definitely wanted to capitalize on the fact that the original Most Wanted sold so many millions of copies, so they released Need for Speed Most Wanted, a completely new style game developed by Criterion. Some of the legendary racing designers behind stuff like Burnout. And this, of course, was a solid Need for Speed game for sure, but it just wasn't the same, especially with the career mode. They really didn't totally capitalize on what made the original Most Wanted so special, you know? So anyway, there we are. I'm Most Wanted 2005. Is it the best Need for Speed game ever? That depends. You know, you ask some older fans, maybe not. You ask some newer fans, maybe yes. It doesn't really matter. What matters is that a lot of people had a blast with this one. From the once again awesome hit soundtrack to the over-the-top chases and just the vibe in general. There's a lot of love for Most Wanted and it was well deserved. Now, can we reach this high point again? Who knows? The newer Need for Speed games, the last few, people talk about them definitely a lot less, but there's been a few charming surprises hidden in there. Nothing quite as good or as even successful as Need for Speed Most Wanted, but we're hoping eventually this series can really reach its high points again. But of course, that ball is in EA's court, so who knows, dude. But it is fun to look back. So we want to hear from you guys down in the comments. Need for Speed Most Wanted. Do you have any good stories, any good memories of playing this game alone or with a friend on whatever platform? Let us know. Let us know your favorite car. Let us know your favorite boss mission, any moment in the story. We really want to hear from you guys. But if you enjoyed us taking this trip down memory lane, clicking the like button's all you got to do if you appreciate this video. We thank you for that. But if you're new, consider subscribing, hitting that notification bell because we put out videos every single day. But as always, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time.